Kitty, kitty, kitty. Good morning.
Good morning, world. It is Labor Day and we have no plans. So today I'm hoping to get a lot of stuff done around the house. And I'm gonna film this What I Eat in a Day video. I'm wearing my cool YouTube shirt from Google in Mountain View, California. Very cool. I love this shirt. It's so comfortable. And I'm wearing my Vermeer glasses. Video on my main channel coming for these shortly. And so before I get around to getting any eating done for myself, I am going to get some pumpkins going in the oven to make pumpkin puree. And this is the book I'm working with. I don't remember. Someone gave me this. I don't remember who. Probably someone in my family. But I'm just working with the very first recipe in the entire book, which is pumpkin puree. Which is honestly just stick the pumpkin in the oven and roast it. Puree what's left. So it says 350 degrees, 30 to 40 minutes. I found last time with the pumpkins I had from my garden, I had to do it a little longer than that. It calls for 2.5 pounds of pumpkin, but like you're just roasting pumpkin, it doesn't matter. So that is what I'm gonna get into this morning, making some pumpkin puree, and then I really need to probably make some more pasta sauce today too. And I need to film because I haven't filmed in forever. I just haven't had the mental clarity to just sit and do it. I don't know. Sometimes I get in these like perfectionist streaks where I'm like, I can't do it because it's not gonna be perfect. So stupid. But let me show you what I've got going on. So I've got my baking sheets lined with foil, and then I just sprayed them down with a little of coconut oil spray. And then I have these two pumpkins I need to cut open. Okay, so I cut the head off first. And this one had really thick skin, so hopefully I can actually cut through it. I'm gonna try and sit it down on the flat part and go in this way. I used the elf glove for the other end of the knife. I think I might need my stool. I'm tall now. And I'm gonna cut the pumpkin in half. Pumpkin number one, cut in sort of half. These halves are not even at all. But I guess I'll just have to take this one out of the oven first and cook this one longer, but when they're this hard, you get what you get. Oh, it sounds like Kitty's in the other room playing. So I'm gonna scoop the seeds out, get these down on the baking tray, and cut open my next one. And I don't know if I should keep the seeds or not. So what I did last time is I just scooped them into my stock bag, and I'll use them to boil for stock. So I think I'll just do the same thing. And yeah, I'm probably not gonna keep this. It's just such an odd shape. Gonna sit very strangely in the stock bag. So let me show you that while I'm thinking about it. So I make my own vegetable stock. I'm actually out right now, which is why I'm trying to expedite my stock bag. And I just throw veggie scraps in here. So right now I've got like pumpkin guts and seeds. I've got the head of a cauliflower, like the base of a cauliflower. Some scraps from like the twigs and stuff from herbs, some scraps from peppers, scraps from red onion, scraps from white onion. So just anything veggie related, like the veggie you would cook with, I throw in here. So let me get my spoon. Oh, it must be in the shower. Get my spoon and I just scrape out all these seeds and fleshy guts from the pumpkin and put it in my stock bag. And actually, hopefully sometime this week I have enough in here to make some more stock before we head out to California and I can get this bag out of my freezer. That'd be lovely. Head number two. That one didn't have a little stick though. I did the same thing again and accidentally cut one way thinner, so I'll put both the thick ones on one tray and the thin ones on another so that I can take them all at the same time. Just one tray at a time. So that's what I'm doing. So they're in the oven now. I'm gonna set my timer for a half hour. That's probably all that the little ones are gonna need. And then I'll keep an eyeball on the larger ones. Okay, so for breakfast, I think I'm gonna do a tofu scramble sandwich. So, I have tofu. And these are all the seasonings I use on mine. Use whatever you want on yours. A little bit onion salt, or granulated onion, not onion salt. That'd get too salty. Some garlic, crushed red pepper, turmeric, paprika, and then I also have black salt for the sulfurous taste, and then of course salt and pepper. And before I get to doing that, let me switch the camera around. I have the last few pieces of my tempeh bacon cooking up, which I really like this stuff. I'd buy it again. I think it's Tofurky brand, but I don't remember because we threw away the package when we opened it. So I have that cooking up, and then I'll get this going, and I'm going to clean up the cutting board from all the pumpkin mess. And then I have coffee left over from yesterday because I made it, and then I hardly drank any of it. I can't talk. I hardly drank any of it. But it is this coffee, pumpkin spice coffee from BJ's, and then I added the silk coconut milk creamer, and then some of this almond and coconut milk, because I can only do a little bit of that creamer, it's too sweet. So yeah, that is what's going down here, and then I'll probably, I think there's only two pieces of this bread left, so I'll probably just use it because I don't mind eating the butt of the bread. Austin doesn't like it. His mom doesn't like it. I don't know if I've mentioned that. Hold on. I don't know if I've mentioned that, but she had been staying with us for a little while. She's down the beach now at the condo with grandma, but she should be back shortly to kind of watch the house while we're in California. But she has been staying with us on and off because her house sold, so whenever she's up this way, she'll be at our house, but she'll be at the condo the rest of the time down the beach. And then that's why we have Kitty. I don't know if I've mentioned that in a video yet, but yeah, Kitty has come to live with us for now. So I'm gonna get to cleaning this cutting board and I'll be back. Our tempeh bacon is done. I added all the seasoning into the tofu crumble. And I just have it cooking down. I prefer mine drier, so I used the extra firm tofu. Go down in firmness scale if you like yours wetter. And then I have my toaster toasting. And I guess I just have to figure out what else I want on here. Maybe like some avocado or, I don't know, I think about it. I think I'm gonna add some red onion and a little bit of chipotle mayo from, what's it called, Hampton Creek. Just slice my onion up, and then I'll put the rest of this onion back in the fridge. I do not like using plastic containers for, like, leftovers and stuff, but, like, when I don't finish a whole onion or something, that's what I like to use these for, instead of using, like, a plastic bag. Because we already own them, I figure I need to use them for something. Oh, toast is done. Okay, let's begin to assemble, I suppose. So I'm going to do a little bit of this. Butter knife so I can spread that around. I love that stuff. It is so good. Maybe I'll just do a smidge from both sides. I know this is like not super healthy, but I'm only using the tiniest bit. If it would come out of the bottle, be using the tiniest bit. Okay. I'll lay down our onion. Oh, I got it on my shirt. Oops. And our tempeh bacon. Nope, I lost the peas. And some of this tofu scramble. Maybe she snapped the tofu scramble down first. It's going everywhere. Put it on the other piece of bread. Off the heat. Assemble the sandwich. It's gonna be super messy. Oh my gosh. There's tofu everywhere.
I'm just a mess.
But I guess the fun part is I don't care if I make a mess. I'm not a chef. I don't need to put this picture all over the place.
I just need to eat it.
So let me put stuff away and then I'll show you what we've made.
So here's my mess. I don't really care. Although, let me get those two pieces off the stove. So there's our sandwich. I'm gonna eat it. I have my coffee. I'll check in next time I make something or eat.
So for lunch, I'm going to make a chickpea salad sandwich. And I have chickpeas, some lemon juice, dill, turmeric, paprika, pepper, did a little garlic powder, some nutritional yeast, and I'm going to mash this all up and then add some celery and onion. And then I would probably add olive to mine, but Austin won't like that, and I want to let him try it. So, that's what I'm making. So, Austin didn't want any, so I'm going to go ahead and add some olives. And then I also added some spicy brown mustard, too. This would actually be much better with vegan mayo, but we don't have any vegan mayo right now, so I'm going to get that in there and get it on my bread. So, here's my sandwich. I just put a little lettuce on there. And hand me a cup of OJ and watch the baseball game. So today I made a pumpkin, like, cheesy sauce. I found that on the leancleaneatingmachine.com. I just googled it and that's the one that I had the ingredients for. And then I also added in peas and kale. So here's my bowl. And I put some walnuts on top. Usually I'll top pasta with olives too, but I just didn't feel like this one needed it. And it's really good. If I can remember, I'll post the link to that recipe down below. And this is whole wheat pasta.